Hey folks, hi, good evening. Thanks for joining in, those who are joining in right now, and those will be seeing this later. First of all, thank you so much for some fantastic submissions that came through. I mean, the detailing on them was pretty amazing. As I mentioned, there were the average size of each submission was 10 pages, approximately. So somebody had a deck of 29 slides, though some were questions in that, but it was pretty hectic trying to, you know, get all the submissions scored and then do the visual insights. So that took a little time. Thanks for your patience and thanks for the submission. Yeah, so this was the thing, right? The problem is, as I mentioned in the problem statement, it means different things to different people. Nutrition means different things to different people, but the problem to be solved also is different to different people. If you see the range of solutions that have come in, the ideas are similar, right? You know, tracking, calories, many of the ideas are similar. And then there are those which are nudges related, which I'll talk about now. But the problems that each of them is trying to solve is slightly different, right? Slightly different. So if you're able to gauge that, I think once you see all the submissions, you'll see that, you know, there is an indexation that we've kind of favored the ones which have gone for nudges rather than the ones which have gone for direct solutions to problems, you know, because the reason being that there is no direct solution to a problem which people don't think is a problem at all. At least that's for the segment that, as I said, our bias kind of feels, right? And I think that slide from Anshul will definitely help convey that one. Okay, so this is from, again, Shahid. And both of these are actually books that have won Nobel Prizes. Authors have won Nobel Prizes for these books. I'm sure you'll recollect these books. If you don't, just ping, I'll happy to share the links to those books. But what he says, and makes a lot of sense, right? The minute you open, I think Swiggy is slightly more tempered, but the minute you open Zomato, you're bombarded with things that will activate you, which is offers, right? Offers, buy, nice imagery of food, you know? And he says there are two parts to the brain, which is what thinking fast, thinking slow is all about. There is the logical side, and then there is the side which, you know, instinctively reacts. And this is all reaction-based. And I guess that is the intent, right? You know, because, and I'll come to this transactional app part later and why it has to be this way. It cannot be what we want it to be. But he says, why not nudge people to it, right? So he puts in a nudge here. I personally feel this is a good nudge, but it is a little too weak to actually push somebody to decide on changing their behavior. See, we have to do changing behavior. Somebody's behavior is not at all easy. In fact, that is the most difficult thing, especially for somebody who's used to a certain set of behavior within a certain app. So while the idea is nice, maybe a little bit more depth, a little bit more classifiers would have helped. That we are living in times which are different. Like same thing 2 years ago, we would not really be thinking too much. We would say it's faff. Right? But today it really does matter. I'm sure each of you has gone through this phase where you're thinking of what you're doing in life, as well as in that includes how you're living your life, in which there is a certain part, which is what are you eating day to day? I'm sure that has happened. If it's not happened, it will happen. Maybe you're just too young and I'm a little too old, but these are excellent points that have come through some excellent research work. Fantastic. Loved it. But the third factor, which is very important, is that right now is like the fine balance time that Zomato and Swiggy and all these guys are going through. There are very few formal jobs available in the market, right? So most people are out of work, especially people who are low skilled. And obviously the Uber and Olas of the world are not really in demand. So all these people are happy to, you know, do rider jobs and make some money at least. You know, that is ki kuch to paisa ban raha hai. Tomorrow, 5-6 months down the line, when things will improve, if they improve, this may not be the equation. That equation changes very, very quickly. And if you want justification of why that might happen, just look at 1 year back. Zomato was like, everybody was like, yaar, abhi kya karenge log, right? 1 year down the line, everything has changed. So these things are in flux and they can move very, very swiftly. And that is why there is need, not just from this perspective, but also from profitability, because they've listed now, from profitability perspective, to then focus on things that will drive you margins, right? And it's not the fact that, you know, wellness and health will do it, but you need to know that people are getting more conscious about it, right? So if not today, then tomorrow you will have to do it. Why not start doing it today? Is the thought process.